There's nothing else to get if you want me to. I thought we had. Some of them have some.
Did we find it warm yet? That's bad, right? You find it warm?
Yeah.
Okay. Wes, if you want to take your back off. Amy?
Austin's here.
I want you guys to face this way.
Do you act?
10 years ago, would you have thought that the home computer would be in such abundance? How about the convenience of watching a full-length movie in your your own home when you want to see it on your own VCR. Let's take a look at the cameras that we have here today. A home movie, right in the palm of one hand. And what about the car that talks to you when you get into it in the morning? It reminds you to fasten up your seatbelt. Gives you a temperature check and wishes you a good day. Those are all here. Our world is changing. We often say that there are two things that are certainties. Death and taxes. Well, there's a third certainty. There's a certainty of change. We can add that to it. These children will graduate in 1999. What will the world be like then? They tell us that the jobs that will be available in 1999, they're not even in existence now. What will they need to know to get those jobs? They estimate that the amount of knowledge that is being generated, the amount of new knowledge that is being generated over the years, is being generated at double. It's being doubled every 2.5 years, right today. The amount of knowledge that we know. By 1999, by the turn of the century, it will take just 1.8 years for it to double. That's a staggering amount of knowledge. New knowledge, not stuff that we already have, but new knowledge. And people living in this world, we won't be able to keep up with that. As educators and as learners, we won't be able to keep up with that. But the computers will help us out, though, because it'll make it easy for us to get that information when we need it. Through your modems, you can telephone to this information bank or that information bank, and the information will be at your fingertips to generate the proper code words, and away you go. The students of today will need to learn the three R's. That's still important. But they'll also need to know how to find the information that they want. And they'll need to know how to organize it so they can use it properly. They will need to be able to think about this information and make some decisions with this information, and hopefully put it to good use. If you were at the flood meeting last night, what was going on there was a process that will be ever more increasing. We have a meeting in which people were looking for information. They were trying to organize it, and they were trying to make decisions on the basis of that information. And in 1999 and in years to come, that kind of process is going to be ever more increasing. And those are the kinds of skills that our children will need to develop. We're finding that as a society, we're doing that kind of thing more and more. If we're going to serve the larger society, that's the kind of skill that we need to develop. Hopefully schools will be developing those skills. We want not only to develop the three R's, but we want to add also those skills of information retrieval, organizing skills, thinking skills, and probably most important, the communicating skill, being able to communicate that idea. It's not by accident that this year's kindergarten class is not sitting most of their time at desks. Their movement around the room, their involvement in the activities that are going on, are planned. And they're planned so that your children get experience with those very kinds of skills that I've been talking about. And she plans the day so that every child will get an opportunity to experience these skills. And from the outside, we see story time, and we see children playing with blocks, and messy finger painting, and playing with computers, and the trip to the farm, trip to the post office. We see all of those. That's the outside. On the inside, There's something more important going on. These are all play activities, but they're play activities with a design. They're designed to give the children those kinds of experiences of organizing, communicating, and so on. And we do it with play because that's the natural mode of learning for children. They learn all kinds of things through their play. And it's easier for them to learn through their play. Behind all this play, they're learning language, communication. They're learning the organizing of the blocks. They're learning organizing through their finger painting. They're thinking about how they can do this, how they can do that with their finger painting, with their blocks. They're learning math skills. And a very important skill, cooperation. Being able to get along with their friend, their peer, their working partner, whatever. All of these are fundamental skills for tomorrow's world. Hopefully, school will try to continue these kinds of experiences. We want activities which will teach children to read, write, do math, but also those which will teach cooperation, and thinking, and organizing, and decision making. So what should your child earn for $19.99? They will need to read and to write and do math. They will also need skills for successful living, to be able to make good decisions about their lives. The more good decisions they make, the better their lives will be.
Our conductor is Pythos Regas.
Thank you.
Rebecca Rose Goodale, the daughters of Robert and Charlotte. Stephen Eric Hansen, son of Eric and Margaret. Jessica Marie Hitchcock, daughter of Wilfred and Annette. Matthew Larry Kennedy, son of Larry and Brenda. Sandra Lynn Lawrence, daughter of Wayne and Francis. Mark Lindsay Mutch, son of Lindsay and Brenda. Amy Colleen McIntosh, daughter of Rod and Colleen. Wesley Lloyd McLean, son of Maureen and Emmett. Liza Christine Nissen, daughter of Lori and Kendall. Joseph Frederick, Erlen Parker, son of Frederick and Sandy. Katrina Dawn Parker, daughter of Wayne and Sue. Daniel Alexander Price, son of Eric and Stephanie. Congratulations. Iso Robert Schraga, son of Willem and Gail. Matthew Evan Smith, son of John and Joan. Aaron May Elizabeth Cooney, daughter of Douglas and Teresa. Matthew David Waddy, son of David and Anne Marie.
Matthew, congratulations.
We're getting videos done.
I
Thank you.